Remember that the president went for a while, and then he came back. And when he came back, you should have seen the mood of the nation. Even opposition was a bit happy. We were happy that he was back. Because, tell you, for real, the only thing good about that party is Buhari himself. And when the only thing good about their party is Buhari, and we can't see that same person that is good, it then means that a gang of people have not taken over our country and they are running it by themselves.
It means that the acting president and the entire cabinet, which the president himself appointed, are people who are not good. Is that what you're saying?
No. We did not.
You've just insinuated that.
No, I've not insinuated that. You're picking it up wrongly. Let me tell you, the acting president, however he tries, there are attitude and charisma and courage and procedures that you will know that it's only the president that can have it, especially in a country like Nigeria. Nigeria has not developed to the stage where you will say that the man in the office does not matter. Habits, we can also say, yes, now that they've bungled it, the APC has bungled their handling of the matter, their media management of the situation has been warped, they've not done it as we should have expected, as Nigerians would have wanted, or as transparently as they wanted. Maybe the only thing we can gain from this is that they would demystify the presidency.
Is that why members of the opposition have been carrying, you know, all the stories and saying he's been on life support?
No.
Before then, I mean, before the president came back the first time, there were stories of how he was on life support, or he couldn't breathe, he could barely talk, and all sorts of
You're
stories.
You're talking about the...
And then he came back, you know, then, as you rightly said, there was silence. You know, even though at some point people started saying, we've not seen the president in public. It's been, you know, away for a couple of days, or he's not been seen in public. And then later on, we saw him in public. Mm-hmm. But then he said, I was going to be going back for medical treatment and did what he ought to do by the law.
Yes. You're referring to the comments of the chairman of the governors from Governor Ayodele Fawashi. When he said the president was on, when he said he was on life support, it took them a couple of weeks before they brought anything that can suggest that Nigerians can be calm about the matter. Who told you that when somebody is ill and is lying down on life support that it means he's not going to ever recover, he's not going to make some partial recovery? We are not supposed to be driving the narrative on the health of the president from the back. It's supposed to be frontal. It's supposed to be open. It's supposed to be transparent. There is nothing wrong with being ill. It's when you showed everything in secrecy, you create an imagination that some people are manipulating or doing some other thing, and we have a history of cabals insisting that even a caricature should stay in government forever and ever. There's a history
cabals.
In this. There is a history of that.
Presenting what party?
Well, the experiences of the PDP ought to be lessons for the APC if they knew well, if they know what they're doing. If the experiences of the PDP did not provide any real lessons for them, then it means that nothing has changed. And that's what we're saying. Really, if it had been another president and not Buhari, who people think is, you know, stellar qualities, this, that, maybe Nigerians would have actually gone berserk. The only reason why they're not even going berserk in the first instance is because probably it's the person that it is. People know he's fighting corruption. People believe that, okay, this is a good man. But that does not mean that our processes will not work. Let me give you one quick example. God forbid, if a leader in one of the developed countries were to become, you know, incapable of functioning, or he fell ill, within minutes, the protocols would have put out the information that people can follow, because they know that if you don't put information out there, people will invent some. And to stabilize a nation like ours, you need to put information there that reasonable people can become. And please.
Was the information not enough? I mean, because we saw at some point, much later, almost out of the blues, some members of his cabinet, the chairman of the APC and quite a number of governors, you know, visiting him in London and having lunch with him. Because they had been saying, oh, he's okay. I mean, we had heard from his wife. We had even heard from the acting president. And mind you, the same Governor Ayodele Fayoshe said that, you know, the acting president, well, almost what he was saying wasn't true. You know, even though he came back and said, I saw the president and we had a good conversation, his sense of humor was still there.
Okay.
And then then shortly afterwards, we saw that group. And then shortly afterwards, the Nigeria Governors Forum organized a trip for both APC and PDP governors to go and, you know, see the president and, you know, ensure that they give him their best wishes. Wasn't that enough?
Do you know what all of that suggests to us? It suggests that we're not a serious people. If he's well enough to take photograph, if he's well enough to receive team A, if he's well enough to receive the second team, if he's well enough to shake hands, if he's been well enough to receive guests over a month or 2 month period, Why can't he talk to Nigerians?
What would the serious people do? I mean, what would talking to Nigerians, how would he show that?
It's like saying that, why does the president make a broadcast on Independence Day? Is it that the broadcast itself is going to immediately change things? No, he's going to communicate hope. He's going to communicate that I'm your commander-in-chief, I'm your president, this is what's going on, I'm good and all right. Why should people come and tell us he's well when we demand, we want to know that, oh, Your Excellency, how are you doing? You think that if he can receive them and shake them and still keep his humor, a 5 minutes teleconversation would be too much. Anyway, besides that, does all of this not even bring another painful but depressive opinion to your mind? Why should we as a nation not even be able to look after the medical needs of ourselves and our leaders? It's going to be a combination of bricks and bolts to build the building and capacity and equipment to make sure the place runs. What is wrong with us? We had Yar'Adua. He had to go all over the world on all of this crisis. Now we are having Buhari. When are we going to have a hospital that can handle our own issues here?
Shouldn't we put that question to your party? Because as you rightly said, I mean, you have been in power for 16
yes.
years. And in that time, we ought to have been able to develop...
Why do you think the baton changed? The baton changed because they wanted to give another party an opportunity to probably better the situation that was on ground before, as it must be allowed in democracy. But if they've been there for the period that they've been there,
2 years compared to
2 years plus, it's not 2 years exactly, it's almost 3 years. No, but before you know it, it's 4 years gone. And everybody will be asking, what happened here? The nation is more divided. You're seeing the issues of iPod come to the state. I don't know why and who they expect to help them handle that. You give somebody a bill and it's breaching his bail condition. Nothing is happening. Some people are in the north issuing ultimatum. Nothing is happening. People are getting kidnapped and killed. Someone has even gone to the extent of going to church to shoot people during church service. Nothing is happening. If it had been our time, we're just a far more responsible set of people, and we understand what it means to be guarded in our comment. When it was our turn, less a fraction of this would not happen. They would have started running helter-skelter. The civil society, everybody would have been going berserk. And we're looking at Nigeria going, slipping and slipping away before our eyes, and we're saying, why do you think we're asking for the president? We're not asking for the president because he's a superhuman. It's just that great hope that if he's around, maybe he will, you know, use his position and his authority and his clout and probably his reach and experience to stem some of these things. So we're not asking for to be communicated about his health because we are not doctors, but we're just saying we have a right to know. And if we ask, and you are not providing, Nigerians ask, and you are not providing information, and people go and sit down, and a few people sit down there and say, resign or go. You can't act the way you acted. Remember that when we had enough is enough in Nigeria over the oil thing, do you know what the PDP government did then? What we did is that we deployed every arsenal of government to go and engage the people. We did live shows. We did town hall meetings. We brought everybody to explain it. It still did not make them go away. But at least they saw that government is responsive. You cannot react to people agitating for a matter that has gone on for too long, that has become a bit irritating. CNN the other day was even making a joke about Nigeria. That's how we have become. Just because information is not being provided as I went you. That's what it is.
Well, we'll come back and talk a bit more about how the protests have been handled in just a moment. Please stay with us.